Hi there! In this video we're gonna do some Christmas ornaments. Because it's that special time of year and we want to make special stuff for our family, our dear friends, and or for our Christmas tree. And well, we're gonna create this beautiful ornament. And I'll show you different styles that you can make with this beautiful pattern. Subscribe, comment, like the video, and let's go! So, first thing that we're gonna do is this center, like you see here. And we're gonna do one of the center. And let's start. Let's start with this color. So first of all, I will be using different types of yarn, but they are very similar between them. As you can see here, they are very similar in size, and this is Yarn Art Elite, and I have, it's a light yarn, this pinkish color. This one is from Elise. And it's also light yarn. The green one is the same as the first one. And this one is different. This is from Elise, Real 40. And it's a type of wool because I wanted to be soft, not like these others. I wanted to be like this to fit for Christmas patterns and for winter. It's a very beautiful type of yarn. Okay, so let's get started. First thing I'm gonna do is a chain 4. Oh, and I didn't mention, I'm using a 3mm crochet hook. So we're gonna chain 4. And 4. And we're gonna join in the beginning with a slip stitch. Okay. Let's secure this and we chain 1. Now in this middle, it's very tight, but if you pull it, you can see the middle. You're gonna do 12 single crochet. So I'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Now I will join in the beginning, in the chain 1 we did in the beginning. Okay, we chain 1, we cut the yarn, the tail, I pull this out like this and pull it, secure it, and this is our first circle, the first middle we have. That is gonna be the same as this one, the middle. Now, we're gonna choose another color, any color we want. I will choose red. I'm gonna attach the new color by inserting my hook in any of these stitches. The one we did in the first go? No, I'll go in this one. I take the yarn, I pull it, and now I'm gonna leave the tail like this, because we're gonna be working over the all three tails. I will chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Now we're gonna do a puff stitch like this. I take yarn over my hook. I insert the hook in the same stitch as the chain 3. In the same stitch. I take it out, I pull it up to be tall. And again, the second time, I take the yarn over my hook. In the same stitch, I go. And I pull up. I have 2 times. I take the yarn. In the same stitch I go, and I pull it out, and now 3 more times in the next stitch without doing anything. So I take the yarn, I go to the next stitch, not the same one, the next one, and I make sure I take these tails over like this, so I have 1 in the next stitch. I have 2. I take the yarn, insert it. I have 3. Now, what we have to do is to take the yarn and pull it through all these loops I have over my hook. A good tip is to put the tip of the crochet down. So like this, it will slide beautiful. Like this. Now I'm gonna chain 2. And in the next stitch, I will do a slip stitch. In the next stitch. Like this. Now we're gonna start over the same as we did in the first petal. We're gonna chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. I'm gonna do a puff stitch with 3 times in the same stitch and 3 times in the next stitch, like this. So I take yarn over my hook, I take it out, I have 1 time, I put it inside, I take it up, I have 2 times, put it inside, take it out, I have 3 times. Now we go to the next stitch. I take the yarn, put it up, I have 1 time in the next stitch, 2 times, and 3 times. And now, I will take the yarn and pull it through all them, keeping my crochet hook tip down. And pulling up, because if it's like this, it's gonna be hard. I have to pull up to be this very tight. And I slide. Like this. Chain 1, chain 2. Okay, we have to chain 2. And again, I slip stitch in the next stitch. I chain 3. And I do 3 rounds in the first stitch, in the same stitch, and 3 in the next one. I have 3. And in the next one, I make another 3. Chain 1. Chain 2. I always get confused. I have to chain 2 after the puff. Now I slip stitch, chain 3, and again 3 times in the same stitch and 3 times in the next one. So I did 3 here, and I'll do 3 here, One, two, and three. And I'll pull it, roll them. Chain two. And I'll do slip stitch in the next stitch. Chain three. And in the same stitch, I will do three times for the puff and three times in the next one. I did only. You can count them because you should have one the first time, the first loop you had, two for the first time, two for the second time. And you should have seven after the same stitch. You should have seven loops on your hook. And we do three more times on the next stitch, pull it through, chain two. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 petals. I'll slip stitch in the next stitch. Now, before I slip stitch, I will do something else. I'll take these tails and I'll cut them now, because it is enough of waving. Like this, I cut the tails. Put them away. And now we're gonna continue. I will do a slip stitch here. Chain three. And I will do the puff. The last puff. I chain two. You have one more stitch left. I will slip stitch in this one. But because I don't like the space between the first petal and the last one, I will also slip stitch in the next stitch, the one we started this round, to be continuous. Now I'll cut this yarn. Like this, and this is the petal, and this is the what we saw while we worked. This is actually the back. This is the front, and it looks beautiful. And now I'll give you a tip, because what I did here, as you can see, it looks the same. What I did in this one and this one, I sewed them together. I will show you how I sewed them together. But if you want, you can leave it like this. And you take this end and you sew it in, and you leave this loop. And you can put it like this in the Christmas tree. Exactly like this. You can put it in the Christmas tree. And you can have mixed, you can have long ones and you can have short ones, and it will look beautiful. And even in the back, the back has no problem, just it's not, you don't see these puffs like you can see here. The back is okay, just the front, it looks more beautiful. Okay, let's do another one. This one I will do it different, so I can show you how you sew them together. So I have here the first round. I will not make it again because I already made it. But it is made the same way, this color. And now I'll be using this puffy white. So just make the first row as I showed you in the beginning. Thank you. Okay, so I finish 4 of these flowers. And now I'll put them together. As I said, you can use them singular. You don't have to join them. It's just optional. But I will show you how to do it anyway. You put them like this. Of course, like, make this loop good. I just put them on the table. Like this. Okay, so to sew them together, we're gonna do like this. We will put the tip of this petal between two petals here. Like this. It has to be like this. And we're gonna do this in the back. So for every petal, no matter which side, it has to be on the other side. So this petal has to be between these two. So I'll just sew it there. Like this. Now this petal, I'll sew it between these two. It doesn't matter because the back, you'll not see it. Doesn't matter how it looks. Okay, so this middle, we're gonna sew it here between these two. And the red middle, the red petal between these two green petals. One more time to secure it, like this. Beautiful. I will weave this in. Cut the yarn. And this is how you sew two flowers together. You can leave them like this, or you can make long. Like we have here. Different types. So, I hope you enjoyed this pattern. I will have more Christmas decorations for the Christmas tree and for the Christmas table and for presents for our family and friends. I will have more patterns in the future. Actually, this week, I think, I will release another pattern that is good for Christmas. So I hope you enjoyed. See you in the next pattern. Subscribe, comment, like the video, and see you in the next pattern. Bye.